Welcome back, everyone. Showing us how to bring the magic of Christmas to family movie night with our holiday popcorn buckets is Allie.
I mean, come on.
I'm thrilled about this.
Who doesn't love Christmas movies? I mean, come on. You're watching Hallmark Channel right now. You gotta love your Christmas movies. And I feel like this is just such a fun way to, you know, get the kids excited about having your movie night, plopping down on the couch, watching all of your favorite Christmas movies. I know this weekend I'm gonna be watching Jingle Around the Clock because that's airing and Christmas Made to Order. I'll have my bucket, my popcorn, my kiddos. Be good to go.
You'll be ready to go. And I got to say, like year-round, especially during the holidays, but year-round, family movie night is our family, the Matheson family's biggest tradition by far. Really? We try and do it every week. It's a big deal for us. So this is going to be really great. Yeah, they're you know, lots of hugging and loving.
I love your family. They're so sweet.
So that's us in front of the TV. Like, this is where we kind of hunker down, watch our movies, and we spend time together, you know, all the great Hallmark Christmas movies come on, and we're just like locked and loaded, ready to go.
But my family's actually coming to your house to watch on that big screen.
It's fun.
I'll bring the popcorn bowls.
Yes, absolutely. I'll be bringing the one that I make that you're going to show me.
Yes, I am.
What do we need? What materials do we need to make this?
So you need some things to decorate, which I'll show you in a minute. But for the most part, you need your popcorn containers. You can just get these online if you just look up, you know, popcorn containers. Then you're going to want some foam sheets, and you're going to want to use that to decorate the base of your popcorn container. The reason you want to use the foam sheets instead of painting, because you're like, oh, why don't I just paint it?
Yeah.
Usually these containers have like a wax film on the outside of them, and the paint might not stick to it. So I'd say you can use construction paper, or you can use foam sheets. I use the foam sheets. So the first thing you want to do to get the right shape is, I took one of the popcorn containers and I just deconstructed it to get basically the outside of it. So
that's
this
so smart.
I could use as my template.
So that way you know you're getting exactly the right size.
The exact shape.
It's perfect.
So you lay it down in your foam.
Okay.
You trace it, and then you go in. After you've got your trace, you cut it out, boom, 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 boom.
And you've got the exact shape.
Perfect.
I think it's better this way, too, instead of trying to paint it, because then it's going to show through. It might scratch a little bit. And we're going to be adding things to this, like the face. So we want to make sure that it stays. But
absolutely.
In order to put it on the bucket, just a little hot glue?
Yeah, just a little hot glue. Put it around. I'm going to make, there's a bunch of different ones that you can make. If you look over here at all the ones that we did, I'll show you some of the designs. There's a Santa Claus, a reindeer. You can do a little elf or an angel, anything you want. Or you can have fun and make anything. Get creative.
Yeah.
All of the templates, though, for all of these little characters over here are on our website. So if you want to make a particular one, the templates for that are on our website. You can download them there.
How great those look.
Yeah,
I mean, the kids are going to love that. The kids are going to love it. Okay,
so I'm going to make the angel, and you're going to make the reindeer.
I'm ready to go.
Rudolph in particular.
I'm making Rudolph in particular. So
go ahead. We already have our foam board on here. So for the angel face, so if you actually look at all of the faces, basically except for the reindeer, the elf and the Santa and the angel, it's all just a half circle, essentially.
Okay.
It's like a circle, and then you cut it not in half. You leave a little bit more than half at the bottom. Or, again, just get our template online.
Okay.
So all you're going to do, and then you're going to take for the reindeer,
yes,
just a little circle, and then I glued on a little mouth there, and then just a little pom-pom, a red pom-pom for the nose. So all you
got me started, which I appreciate.
Yep, you add some glue to the back.
Right.
See, we can do this, Cameron, together.
I love it.
It's not so hard.
No.
So for the angel face, I'm going to come all the way up to the top of my bowl here. It's easier if you do it looking at it straight on, but I'm trying to show camera, so I'm kind of doing it forward.
Realized too is that obviously because the bucket is curved, you want to make sure you get the glue on all sides too, so it glues all evenly.
Absolutely. And you want to make sure you leave it, yours is a little high, you might want to pull it down just a tiny bit, just because you want to make sure there's room on the top for the eyes. But your eyes, I think they'll fit
I think his eyes are going to be very close to the rest of his face. And not only that, I put it on maybe a little bit crooked, but he's kind of like smiling, he's like a grin on the side.
Exactly.
It's my own personal touch.
He's got some character. So then for my angel face, all I'm going to do is I want to add, I got a little piece of rope. Again, you can like use anything you have around your house to decorate these. And for the rope, I recommend adding the glue to the top of your bucket first, maybe adding a little bit, and then adding a little bit of rope, and then keep going, and then add a little bit more glue, and keep going around with your rope. And you're going to do this until you get all the way around, because all angels need a halo,
I know,
don't they? And then you're adding your eyes.
I'm getting a head start because, you know.
I like what you're doing. And if you're doing with this with kids, too, you don't need to use a hot glue gun. You can use just, you know, more, you know, kid-friendly glue if you want. So I would go all the way around like that. But for time, I'm going to move on to my wings, and you are going to put on your ears and antlers. So
That's right.
The template for both of these on our website, and you're just going to add
some
glue.
For these, just along the edge here, right? So I'm going to make sure I kind of get this just enough. That might be a little much, but I can spread it.
Yeah.
I know it's hot glue. I know hot glue is hot.
Hot glue is hot.
I'm tough. There we go.
And you add them on. I'm going to put my wing to the other side. So simple. And these are, like I said, you can let the kids get creative with this, kind of come up with whatever they think. If you want it to look a certain way, you can use our template, but how are you doing over there?
I'm hanging in. So now we've got the buckets done, or at least we tried to.
Yes.
We need some popcorn.
We do.
Okay.
So I think you can have fun with the popcorn. You can use just regular popcorn, but you can also use like popcorn where you have like candies in it and pretzels and all different things.
Oh man, I'm coming to your house.
You know, also if I were coming to your house, I would bring this very special bucket that we have right
here. What? Are you kidding me?
For your family movie nights.